To the Lord. Hallelujah. Ain't you thankful for the Holy Ghost? Hallelujah. We need the Holy Ghost. We need that Holy Ghost and fire. Amen. So thankful it's Pentecost Sunday. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
It's enough to fire anybody up. I understand, you know, we celebrate the birth of the church today in that upper room where God poured his spirit out upon 120. And I'm so thankful he continued to spill out, and he's spilling out today. Amen. So thankful for the Holy Ghost. We need the Holy Ghost. I know a lot of people make fun of it, but you can't even go to the grocery store and not need the Holy Ghost anymore. Amen. It's that important to have the Holy Ghost to lead us and to guide us and to keep us on that path. Amen. So thankful we celebrate it today. Amen. On Pentecost Sunday, if you're able to stand, amen, we're going to go for the Lord in prayer because we believe in the power of prayer and the power of healing. Amen. We need to continue to pray for the Neese family, for Sister Neese. Lord, we'll continue to touch there, and Brother Neese as well. Give him strength as they go through this process. Amen. Lord's will. Amen. And then we'll continue to lift up Sister Patty, continue to lift her up during her treatment. The Lord will continue to touch and comfort there, and also be with Brother Vernon during this time as well. Sister Anderson is requesting prayer for her son-in-law, Barry. He has had some health issues and has taken a turn to the worse. Amen. I'm so thankful we know a God who is a healer. Amen. Brother Chris Hall also has asked requests. He works in a jail, and several inmates have approached and saying they'd like to have prayer for themselves and families. Amen. What an avenue, you know, to be a witness there. Amen. And to be in a situation like that, pretty sure many of us in our workplace and all that, have people approach us because who we are, what we resemble, amen, and the power of testimony, but those families are requesting prayer, amen, and we know the God who answers prayers, amen, every special unspoken, amen. If you want to take up the hedge, bridge that gap, you need prayer for yourself this morning, amen. The Spirit of the Lord's here, the old's here, the elder's here, and we can pray the prayer of faith, amen. Knowing that God will move. Every special unspoken, let's go before the Lord. Lord, we love and we praise you, Lord, and we come humbly before you this morning, Lord. Asking, Lord, for you to touch every name lifted up here, Lord. Lord, every specific need, Lord, as we cast all our cares at your feet, Lord. Knowing that you're the balm of Gilead, Lord, you're the great physician, Lord. As we stand upon your word that by your stripes we are healed. Thank you. Lord, we declare your glory. We declare your healing in Jesus' name. Let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. Smile at your neighbors. You're being seated. Amen. God is so good. Looking out here, a lot of you got the white on, man. Y'all look sharp. Amen. God is so good. It's Pentecost Sunday, man. Just excited about what God wants to do. Tuesday is our prayer and fasting. Amen. Come up here together, church, corporate body, and prayer. Amen. It's also our fast day. Amen. Nothing like having a move of God. Also on Tuesday, Sister Sanderson has the book club that meets at noon at Bob Evans. If you're able to be a part of that, please take a part of that. And Wednesday will be our Bible study and Kids Power Hour. And the youth, Friday night, you have youth night from 6 to 8:30. Amen. And then the men's, a reminder, put this on your calendar. June 1st, men will be having a cookout. I forgot to put down, I believe you said 6 o'clock. Amen. There's a sign-up sheet in the vestibule. If you have any other questions, see Brother Singer. Amen. On that note, our ushers are going to come. We're going to give unto the Lord. Luke 6 and 38 says, "Give, and it shall be given unto you. Good measure, pressed down and shaken together and running over, shall men give into your bosom. For with the same measure that ye meet withal, it shall be measured to you again." We truly cannot outgive God. Lord, we love and we praise you, Lord. And ask, Lord, that you just bless this offering, allow it to multiply, Lord, in the lives of those that are given, Lord, and those that will be touched by it. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Revealed a power of prophecy. Today is Pentecost. Jesus has ascended, and in Jerusalem the disciples are waiting on a promise of a new kind of baptism, not of water, but of the Holy Spirit. Today, the church was born. The Spirit fell like fire, and a power like no other was revealed. A power of prophecy, a power of visions and dreams. People from every nation under heaven hearing the disciples declare the wonders of God in tongues they've never spoken, hearing the gospel in their own language. This is Pentecost. A time of signs and wonders, a time of fellowship and prayer, a day to cry out to Jesus, a day to repent and be baptized, a day to ask for forgiveness and receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. This is Pentecost.
Power with release the sound. Release the sound. About all the silence behind the prison walls, but when they started singing, those walls they had to fall.
There is a sound that makes walls fall down.
There is a sound.
Release the sound.
Release the sound. The crucified Jesus was buried in his tomb.
They thought his life was over.
Release the name.
Release the name.
100,000 people and at Penn State, and it's so loud. I've been in those environments, and that is noise, and it's loud, and our culture just goes crazy about it. But we got something our culture needs. We got something that's greater than that. And I'll tell you, that tells you right there, people are looking for it. They want something that's bigger than themselves. They want something, hallelujah, that's greater than them. Hallelujah. It's going to be hard to contain it this morning, but if you have your Bibles, let's go to Luke 24. Come on, I believe God's beginning to shift some things, hallelujah, in the spiritual atmosphere. God's beginning to take this church. I'm telling you, you're going to see a multitude that you've never seen before. Hallelujah, the parking lot's not going to be big enough. If you think that's not true, fine. You can believe it. But I believe in apostolic authority and apostolic dominion. Hallelujah. They can preach what they want to preach, but we got the truth. And when you got the truth, people want the real thing. Verse 44 in Luke 24, then he said to them, these are the words which I spoke to you while I was still with you, that all things must be fulfilled, which were written in the law of Moses and the prophets and the Psalms. What does he say here? Concerning me. Hallelujah. He was in the beginning. Hallelujah. And he opened their understanding that they might comprehend the scriptures. Then he said to them, thus it is written, and thus it was necessary for Christ to suffer and to rise from the dead the third day, and that repentance and remission of sins should be preached in his name to all nations, beginning at Jerusalem. Beginning where? Say, Jerusalem. Hallelujah, and you are witnesses of these things. Behold, I send the promise of my Father upon you. But tarry in the city of Jerusalem until you are endued with power from on high. This morning, I want to preach this message to you, power from on high. Power from on high. If you read that last verse in the ESV, it says, until you be clothed with power from on high. Are you filled with his power this morning? Let's pray. Jesus, we thank you. God, we come before you this morning. We thank you for the day of Pentecost, God, when you poured out your spirit. We thank you for the gift of your spirit, God. And may you feel, God, anyone in this house today that doesn't have the Holy Ghost, may you fill them with your spirit this morning, God. We love you, Jesus. We thank you for your truth and for your message, God. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You may be seated. Throughout the Gospel of Luke, Jesus had walked with these disciples. Jesus ate with these disciples. Jesus taught these disciples. They saw Jesus heal the sick, give sight to the blind, feed the multitudes, calm the wind and the waves. They now are experiencing his resurrection from the dead here in Luke 24, after they were scattered in fear at his crucifixion. They went from betraying him, denying him, running scared from what killed him, to now sitting with him as he is alive again. Jesus was a teacher, and he's now teaching them and pouring into them as he knows his ascension is drawing near. He knows their hearts and minds are still fearful. He knows they are worried about Rome and the Sanhedrin. He knows they are hoping he will use his power to conquer Rome and the governing authorities. They're interested in his power, but they're looking for an earthly power. Why? To settle the score. Be careful when you want power to settle the score. I can stand before you and testify, I've seen Pastor Heideball. He never has to settle the score. That's true power. When Jesus was being crucified, he opened not his mouth. That's true power. Jesus is not interested here in giving them earthly power or power from the world. He is interested in giving them power from on high. A power that would transcend this natural world. A supernatural power that would enable them to be the church. That would enable them to be witnesses in Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, and to the uttermost parts of the earth. He wants to give you power this morning to be a witness right here in Middletown, Ohio. But what power are you interested in? Are you interested in power from this world? Oh, you can make more money in your job because you need more power. You need this or you need that. We've seen power corrupt. Look at politics. Hallelujah. In the highest authorities, they get power. And what does it do? It corrupts them. But Jesus came to bring us a power that would never corrupt you. Hallelujah. A power that would transcend this world. A power that you could witness in this world. How many Hollywood stars and rock stars and singers got the power and committed suicide? Because that power will never fill you, but the power of the Holy Ghost will transform and change you. Hallelujah. It will give you influence with people, and people will love you. And they won't love you for what you have in the world, but they'll love you because you gave them Jesus. We've seen too many apostolic ministers trade the power of their influence because they have the Holy Ghost and they preach this great truth. Give it away. Acts 1, 3 through 8, to whom also he showed himself alive after his passion by many infallible proofs, being seen of them 40 days and speaking of the things pertaining to the kingdom of God. And being assembled together with them, commanded them that they should not depart from where? Jerusalem. But wait for the promise of the Father, which saith he, you have heard of me. For John truly baptized with water, but ye shall be baptized with the Holy Ghost not many days hence. When they therefore were come together, they asked of him, saying, Lord, will thou at this time restore again the kingdom of Israel? Why do they ask that? They're worried about a conquering Messiah. They want him to settle the score in Rome. They want the power back in Rome, but they want an earthly power back. Jesus wasn't interested in that. Have you ever noticed you ask God for something? Physically? Materialistically? And he doesn't even answer. And he starts talking to you about a soul. He's interested in his kingdom. And if we want God and we want the power of him, we need to become interested in his kingdom. Hallelujah. But you shall, here's what he said. And he said unto them, it is not for you to know the times or the seasons which the Father has put in his own power. See, God controls all of that. We got people that worry so much about politics and what's going to happen. Hey, what's going to happen is what God wants to happen. Because his church is not dependent upon what happens in Washington. Come on, hear me out. His church isn't dependent upon what happens in Washington. So you can worry all day. You can consume all the news you need to consume. But at the end of the day, God's going to sort it out. But ye shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you, and you shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem and all Judea and Samaria and unto the uttermost part of the earth, which would include Middletown, Ohio. Come on, hallelujah. There's something that's getting ready to shift around here. But it's time that we walk in power, hallelujah, from on high, and not power from this world. Sorry if I'm getting a little excited. We need the power from on high, because they won't stay if they don't see the power. The power Jesus is talking about is a power that transcended the four walls of the upper room. It would go from Jerusalem to Judea to Samaria and unto the uttermost parts of the earth. It didn't stay in Jerusalem. The power that you feel in this building today is not meant to stay here, but it's meant to go with you. It's meant to be upon you. It was not meant to be contained in a building, but it was meant to be upon you wherever you go. me talk to you about the power of God from on high. A couple Sundays ago, I was getting ready for church, and I saw my wedding photo. I'm a lot skinnier then. And I saw all those guys in my wedding. And I said, man, I really lost connection with a lot of them. Whew. And there's one that I was thinking about in particular. And my phone was in the living room. And right after that, I pick up my phone and I get a text from one of those guys that I had not talked to in years. What was God do? He was ordaining a God connection. Hallelujah. And we're going to get together this summer and have lunch. Hallelujah. I implore you this morning to get the power of God from on high upon you. Hallelujah. Let it fill you and begin to look for people. Begin to connect with people. Hallelujah. This wasn't meant for just us and to sit on a pew, but it was meant, hallelujah, that we impact people for the kingdom. You are the church. Wherever you go, hallelujah, but you need the power from on high. When people see you and talk to you, they need to feel Jesus. They need to see Jesus. They need to experience Jesus. They need to know there's something different about you. They may not know what it is, but they begin to wonder and they begin to ask questions. This is only possible with power from on high. Without power from on high, we are left to our own devices, and our own devices will never reach anyone. We need the power from on high. Hallelujah. I remember walking into the YMCA years ago, and there was a woman standing there on the steps, and I had been praying and fasting. I told this story before, but the power of God from on high was upon me, and I baptized her in the pool at the YMCA, and a man said, I've never seen anything like this. Come on, church, it's time we get the power back. It's time, hallelujah, that we be the church to this world. We can no longer be the church just right here. Can't just be the church in the building. We can't just put our fancy suit on. We've got to be real to this world. We've got to be transformed by the Holy Ghost. When we live with power from on high, it will create a curiosity within people. They will want to know. We were meant to walk in that power. Hallelujah. To make connections with people. But when we make connections, we create impact. They feel the power, and they want to hear about Jesus. Hallelujah. I ask you today, do you have the power from on high? We don't know where the power can take us. There can be more churches planted. Come on, True Tabernacle, don't get limited. Come on. God can plant more churches. More youth on fire for God. More middle-aged people on fire for God. More elders on fire from God. Come on, elders, don't think it's over. Don't think it's done. God has more for you. Come on, sister. Blackford, I'm coming to the taco bar. Come on. Come on. Hey, hallelujah. Come on, God has more. There's so much ministry in this place. Hallelujah. Come on. More Bible studies taught. More new souls added to the kingdom. More pastoral ministry developed. More world changers developed. More leaders developed within the church. Woo! Power from God can create vision, and it can create visionaries. Hallelujah. It carried the disciples to do things the world thought not was possible. With man, it is not possible, but with God, all things are possible. He's made all things possible by His Spirit, and His Spirit gives us power from on high. going to be the sons and daughters of God, we got to be led by the Spirit. Hallelujah. One through four. Hallelujah. And when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord in one place. They weren't divided. They weren't fighting with each other. Come on, the enemy will stir up stuff between people. But remember, we're fighting the enemy. We're not fighting each other. We're on the same team. It's not about your kingdom, it's about His kingdom. We've got to get radical about His kingdom and not our own kingdom. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were sitting, and there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as of fire, and it sat upon each of them, and they were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with tongues, with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. When you get the Holy Ghost, you're going to speak in another tongue. Hallelujah. He's going to fill you with a supernatural language. A language that comes from heaven. We're seeing the chaos in our world. We're seeing the protests. We're seeing the tearing down of everything. And what's happening? People can't tame the tongue. So what did God do? He said, I'm going to transcend all of it, all this world. And when I fill you, I'm going to tame your tongue. And you're going to begin to speak in my language, a language from heaven. Come on, Pastor talked about it on Mother's Day, waking up and hearing his mother speaking in tongues. Hallelujah. There is a power in the Holy Ghost that can pray for you when you don't even know what to pray for and you don't even understand it. But the power of the Holy Ghost can begin to speak through you. He didn't fill you with the Spirit to be quiet about it. Come on, brother. We must tell all men about it. We must tell all men about Jesus. Power from on high is a drawing power. It draws man to Jesus. We must have the power from on high, and we've got to be led by the Spirit so that men are drawn to Jesus. The friendship of the world is enmity against God. Have you ever noticed if you have a lot of things, people want to be your friend. But the moment you lose all those things, they don't want to be your friend anymore. How many of you have been there? You've had everything. You've lost everything. Then God gave you back stuff. But you stayed faithful to Him. And guess what? You got friends sitting right here. This is where your friends are. So Jesus, he compels us. And when we talk to people about Jesus, He doesn't want them to stay in the world. He wants them to become a friend. Hallelujah, in the church. Come on, and a friend of Jesus. I ask you, do you live a life of power from on high? Are you walking in the Spirit right now? Or are you walking in the flesh? We get the results that we get based on how much the Spirit is operating in us. You would get the results that we get. Do we spend time in prayer? Do we study His Word? We cannot expect certain results if we don't walk in the power from on high. The power from on high needs to be activated, and it's activated by spending time in the presence of God. How much time are you spending in the presence of God? If you have lived entertainment all week and you walk into the house, what power do you have? We've got to get to a place where we can push back entertainment and get consecrated unto God so that His power can come upon us. Hallelujah. This is the most entertained generation I've ever seen in my life. But it's time, hallelujah, that the Word of God becomes entertaining to us. Hallelujah. Oh, a Holy Ghost-filled service becomes entertaining to us. Teaching a Bible study becomes entertaining to us. is the gospel? Because Mary Faye and I get hit with a lot of stuff about what the gospel is all the time. Hallelujah. Therefore, let all the house of Israel know assuredly that God hath made the same Jesus, whom ye have crucified, both Lord and Christ. Now, when they heard this, they were pricked in their heart and said unto Peter and to the rest of the apostles, men and brethren, what shall we do? Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. You have got to repent. You got to say, God, I want to serve you, and I don't want to serve sin anymore. I don't want that life anymore. I want to surrender my life to you. Today is the day of salvation, and today is the day that some of you wave the white flag right here and say, God, I'm done with my life. I'm done with living the way I want to live, and I want to live for you, and you will experience true repentance. And then you got to go down. You got to be baptized in the water in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sins. Because you can come here and repent, but you've got to get your sins washed away. You've got to get the sins taken away. And then you got to be filled with the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Jesus died. He was buried. And he rose again. That's the gospel. And we must repent and be baptized in his name and filled with his spirit. If you don't have this power from on high today, you can have it in this altar. You can repent of your sins, be baptized in his name, and then you will speak in other tongues. If you want it today, you can have it. All you need to do is repent of your sins right here at this altar. Ask God to fill you. See, if you keep reading in Acts, this promise is for you. It's for your families. It's for generations to come. You don't have to walk around out in this world without the power. You don't have to walk around in chains and in bondage and in depression and without hope. There is hope today. There's a hope that's right here in this place. You can have this hope and you don't have to wait another day. There is power from on high here, and his name is Jesus. Until you submit to God, until you say, God, I'm done with this life, the enemy will plague you, and he will continue to destroy you and come after you. But the moment you surrender your life to God, hallelujah, Jesus is there, and he'll pull you out of that life. And he'll fill you with his most precious spirit. Hallelujah. There is nothing like being filled with the Holy Ghost. There is nothing like when the power of God comes upon you. Begins to fill you. Hallelujah. I gotta get finished. They waited for the promise of the Father. They were endued with power from on high. If you read down in Acts 2, it says, praising God and having favor with all people. And the Lord added to the church daily such as should be saved. And my wife and her, just such incredible way of wisdom. Because I worry about the church all the time. She'd say, nobody cares. Jesus cares about the church more than you care about the church. Hallelujah. And what's the scripture say? The Lord added to the church daily. You know what? We gotta quit worrying about growth. What we gotta start worrying about is ministry. If we have effective ministry, we will have effective growth. And the Lord will add to the church. But hear me out, to have effective ministry, you can't do ministry with no power. It just won't work. We need the power from on high. And so many of have the power, but is the power dormant? It's time to reactivate the power. It's time to consecrate yourself unto Him and say, God, I want You to use me in this hour. I'm hungry to see revival. And they continuing daily with one accord in the temple, breaking bread from house to house, did eat their meat with gladness and singleness of heart, praising God and having favor with all the people. That's what the church should look like. Church, we can have a Book of Acts church right here in Middletown. The Book of Acts can continue right here with us as a church, but we need the power from on high. I ask you today, do you have the power from on high? Sorry, I'm just in the Book of Acts today. Is that okay? Oh, man. Do we still love the Book of Acts? Do we still love being apostolic? Come on, our methods are going to change. It's that those things happen. Methods change. But the message can never change. Acts 4:11, this is the stone which was rejected to you by builders, which has become the chief cornerstone. Nor is there salvation in any other, for there is no other name under heaven given among men, which by we must be saved. If you will call upon that name today, the name of Jesus, He will hear you, and He will come near. He is here to change you, transform you, and give you power from on high. You can have power from on high today. You can walk in that power. You can become a new person in Jesus, and you can change the legacy of your family. You can be a world changer today. There's too much. I got to finish. So it was Mother's Day. My mom and dad don't go to church here. My dad used to work with Brother Neese. So I'm hoping, I'm praying one day. And that's a connection for him. It's Brother Neese. But I felt God say to me, what if they never walk in that building? Can you be the church to them? And we begin on Mother's Day just to talk about Jesus. Come on. I know we want to run to the doctrine as we encounter people, but that'll come. We just got to share Jesus with them. Hallelujah. Because they don't know. They don't know that there's a greater power. Cornelius, if you read Acts 10, Cornelius was a man after God's heart. He was that typical Christian that loved God. He feared God. He just didn't know there was more. And what's Peter doing? God, man, I get frustrated because I feel like Peter sometimes. Like, God, why do I always get in trouble? So God begins to give Peter a vision. And He begins to change Peter's mindset. That Peter, this isn't just for the Jews. This isn't just for Jerusalem. And he goes to Cornelius' house, and he shows Cornelius the way. What's the Bible say? Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. And this message from the beginning, and who we are as apostolics and our heritage, it's the way. And all these things happened, right? That convoluted the way and came along in our world, but we can't leave these principles. Hallelujah. We got to stay rooted and grounded. Because even if they believe, just accept Jesus as your Savior, they're going to feel what we have and say, maybe I need something more. And they're going to be like Cornelius, and their whole household's going to be saved. But we've got to make a decision today at this altar that we want power from on high. You cannot trade your soul for the power of this world. There's going to be decisions that you face that may give you power from the world, but it'll take away power from God that is in you. And you're going to face those decisions. And I remember coaching football, and I'm standing on that field, and I'm ministering. I'm working. I'm coaching football. I said, I don't know if I'm going to make it. The rapture. And I just felt God saying, I got something greater for you. Peter, I know you love to fish, but I'm going to make you a fisher of men. Hallelujah. He can make you a fisher of men today. But you got to be transformed with the power from on high. Let's all stand. The musicians would come. If you study Acts 8, you'll see Simon the sorcerer. The people thought Simon the sorcerer, this great man of power, and he had troubled these people with his sorceries. People begin to believe, and they think that's the power. And what happens? The disciples show up, and they bring the message of the way. Hallelujah. And then he offers money because he wants the ability to lay hands on people, and they get the Holy Ghost. And Peter says, your money perishes with you. This gift today, this power, you can't pay enough tithes to get that power. That power comes on repenting from your sins and saying, God, fill me with your spirit. I need your spirit right now. I don't want to walk any longer in this world without your spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I remember walking around my dorm room my freshman year. I said, God, how am I going to make it? There is sin and debauchery all around me. But I had the Holy Ghost. Got at 18 years old. God filled me with his spirit. I didn't even have Jesus' name baptism yet. And he kept me. He kept me through that whole year. And then before you knew it, there were athletes from the university that come into church with me. Apostolic church. And God was beginning to move so powerfully. Come on, we can change this world. It doesn't have to stop in Acts 2. In Acts, at the end of the book of Acts, it don't have to stop with the book of Acts. But the book of Acts can continue right here. Hallelujah, come on. You can be filled with his spirit today. If you don't have the Holy Ghost, hear me out. If you don't have the Holy Ghost, you can come down here and you got to repent. You got to say, Jesus, I don't want that life anymore. I'm giving my life to you. And you surrender. And when you surrender, say, fill me with your spirit. And you're going to begin to speak in other tongues. Now hear me, the enemy's going to show up and he's going to say that language is not from God. But you speak those words anyway. You speak those words anyway. And I remember God at 18 years old. I'm in my truck and I'm like, what are these words? What are these words? And I walked into a Pentecostal service and I said to the ministry, can you tell me? Tell me what these words are? And they began to pray for me. And it was confirmation that I had received the gift of the Holy Ghost. But what was happening? The enemy was plaguing my mind that that's not from God. That's not really God. But those words were coming from heaven. And I was filled with the Holy Ghost. Let's begin to pray. Saints, pray people through today. Come on, can we help people get the Holy Ghost today? Hallelujah, Jesus, we love you. All over this place, God, let the power of your spirit, God, begin to come down. Begin to fill people with your spirit in Jesus' name. The altar is open. Hallelujah. Come on down. Even if you've got the Holy Ghost, let the power be reactivated in you. Come on, become filled. Hallelujah. Today, let the power.
Name of Jesus.
thank you, church, for being here today. Pentecost Sunday, amen. We're going to come back here tonight. Brother Tyler will be preaching. Let's come back in here tonight with expectation of God's move tonight. Hallelujah. Let's pray as we are dismissed. Thank you, Jesus. We praise you, God, for what you've done in this place, God. The power of your move, God. The move of the Spirit, God. We thank you, Lord. Let us come back tonight, God, with expectation, God, that you're going to pour out your Spirit, God, again tonight. We love you. We praise you, God. Be with your people this day. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You are dismissed. Amen.